Enable file history in Windows 11. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. File history is an interesting feature. What it does when it's enabled is it notices when the files in your user directory have changed. And when they change, it backs them up to an external drive. Seems very simple. It checks periodically and does the backup transparently in the background. However, it's not at all obvious how to set it up. And of course, it's not set up by default. So what we're going to do is turn it on in this video so that you've got file history backing your files up. I do want to be very clear about something before we start though. File history is not a replacement for a system image backup. If, for example, your entire hard drive fails, it's your system image backup that will allow you to restore your system, all of your installed programs, and whatever files were on the machine at the time the image backup was taken. File history gives you the more current version of those files that you've actually been changing since that backup image had been taken. So they're used in conjunction. We're doing a system image backup to make sure the entire system is backed up periodically. And by turning on file history, we're getting the most recent changes to the files you're actually working on. So with that out of the way, let's go turn it on. Windows 11 is a little weird about file history. I'm going to click on the start button and just start typing file history. And you'll see that what comes up is file history in control panel. This is actually different than Windows 10 for some reason, but it's what we have and it's what we're going to run with. What file history will do is it will look for external hard drives that it can use to perform the backup function. In my case, it actually found my faux USB drive and is making it optionally available for me to use. Since it's the only drive I have available for this function, all I really need to do is turn it on. File history is now doing its thing. What file history is backing up is the files that are in your user directory. So your documents, your videos, and so forth. It is not backing up files outside of your user directory. So this is a per user kind of thing. Now there are some things that you can do to basically fine tune what does and does not get backed up. To begin with, we'll hit exclude folders. Now we have nothing excluded yet, but for example, if I wanted to, I could say, you know what? My videos, I don't need to back those up with file history. So it's added. Now what will happen is anything that happens in my videos folder will not become part of the file history backup. It will keep the file history backup smaller and perhaps even a little bit quicker, but it does mean then that we're relying on other techniques perhaps to back up videos. Maybe they don't change very often and your system image backup will do what you need it to do. So excluded from file history, we've done that. The other options are over here in advanced settings. Now, save copies of files. File history works by polling. It actually checks the files every so often. And you can adjust the every so often to be whatever it is you like. You can do it as quickly as every 10 minutes. The issue there, of course, is that if you're changing files frequently, then more files are going to accumulate in file history. Every hour is a fine default, but if you want to, you can, of course, make it more frequent or less frequent if you so desire. Keep saved versions forever. This basically will keep the backed up versions of the files as long as it possibly can. You can, of course, turn that into until the space is needed, which is actually probably the most useful. What that means is that the oldest files will start to be removed if file history starts to run out of space on the backup drive. So we'll save changes. And now we do in fact have file history turned on and saving the files we change as we change them. Now, of course, with those files backed up, you'll want to know how to get back to them, how to restore them. And that'll be in a future video. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/164161. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.